Beth and David, the Lord said to Eli the Tishbite, start down to meet Ahab, king of Israel, who rules in Samaria. He will be in the vineyard of Naboth, of which he has come to take possession. This is what you shall tell him. The Lord says, after murdering, do you also take possession? For this the Lord says, in the place where the dogs lift up the blood of David, the dog shall lift up your blood too. Ahab said to Elijah, have you found me out, my enemy? Yes, he answered, because you have given yourself up to doing evil in the Lord's sight, I am bringing evil upon you. I will destroy you and will cut off every male in Ahab's line, whether slave or freeman in Israel. I will make your house like that of Jeroboam, son of Nebat, and like that of Baasha, son of Ahijah, because of how you have provoked me by leading Israel into sin, against Jezebel too, the Lord declared. The dog shall devour Jezebel and district of Jezreel. When one of Ahab's line dies in the city, dogs will devour him. When one of them dies in the field, the birds of the sky will devour him. Indeed, no one gave himself up to doing of evil in the sight of the Lord as did Ahab, urged on by his wife Jezebel. He became completely at that bottom by following idols, just as the Amorites have done, children of Israel. When Ahab heard these words, he tore his garments and put on sackcloth over his bare flesh. He fasted, slept in the sackcloth, and went about subdued. Then the Lord said to Elijah the Tishbite, have you seen that Ahab has humbled himself before me? Since he has humbled himself before me, I will not bring the evil in this time. I will bring the evil upon his house during the reign of his son. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Have mercy on me, O God, in your goodness. In the greatness of your compassion, wipe out my offense. Thoroughly wash me from my guilt, and of my sin, cleanse me.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
For I acknowledge my offense, and my sin is before me always. Against you only have I sinned, and done what is evil in your sight.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Turn away your face from my sins, and blot out all my guilt. Free me from blood guilt, O God, my saving God. Then my tongue shall revel in your justice.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Holiness of God. we are saying, that our Father prayer, God is asking us to have His holiness to dwell within our body so that we represent Him well as His disciple through the person of Jesus. And if we can begin to be more mindful of that reality, that holiness is loving others the way God loves others. We can do fraternal correction. We can tell our enemy what they have done is wrong. But we don't have the right to hate. Hate brings a heart of murder within us. And look at Ahab and Jezebel. They hated Naboth because he told them simply no. And as a result of not having that holiness within their heart, they caused, falsely accused, and caused his death. And that's why the Lord is asking us today in this gospel to love you, to love your neighbor, and not to hate your enemy, but to love the enemy and your neighbor. And in that way, you are free. In that way, you are a peacemaker. And in that way, you truly are a child of God. Amen. Let us not thank our God. Let us pray for outpouring of the Holy Spirit in all of our hearts, especially during these dark days that we live in, that people will be enlightened by the truth of who Jesus Christ is, so that we begin to love one another the way we were called to love one another. And for this we pray to the Lord. And let's pray for the coronavirus to come to an end throughout our planet and our world, our nation, our state. And for this we pray to the Lord. And let's pray for to the end of the sin of racism and abortion for all the land that's plaguing our world so much. For these things we pray to the Lord. And let us pray that God bounds up all the evil spirits and Satan and cast them out.
anything I ask of the Lord, only this do I seek, to live in the house of the Lord all the days.